We'll start the today's session. In the previous class, we have discussed, we'll recap the things what we have discussed in the previous classes. We have started with a chapter called Shell, the Shell Cycle. What is this Shell Cycle is all about? What actually the complete cycle of the Shell is? Actually, when you open the Unix operating system, when you load the Unix operating system, whenever you open this, when you click on this icon terminal, it will open the terminal and it will wait for the user to enter. This is called prompt. It will throw the prompt for the user. The user can enter the inputs, and then what is the next job? The next job belongs to the shell. The shell will search for the meta characters in the commands what I entered. If anything meta characters like the star or any redirection operator or any meta characters are there in the commands, it is going to check the shell. Then it is going to simplify the command line. After simplification, it is going to send it to the kernel for the execution. Once it simplifies the commands, then it will send it for the command will, simplification is nothing but you may have written just two words, ls space chapter star, but it will be replaced like this, ls space chapter one. How many files are there in the directory it is going to check? Chapter one, chapter two, chapter three, all the file names, if the command line will be replaced with a big command, ls space chapter 1 space chapter 2 chapter 3 chapter 4 chapter 5, and then that command, that is called as a simplified command. Means simplification means there will be no meta characters. Once it is simplified, all the meta characters it will be replaced with some other file names or some other parameters, anything. Once that is being simplified, that will be sent for the kernel for execution. Then the kernel will execute. Until that time, the shell will be in the waiting state. Shell will be in the waiting state, meaning it is not ready to receive any other keyboard input or any other command input. It is not going to take. Then just it is going to move to the waiting state. Once the kernel returns the output, it is going to show that output on the screen. Then it is going to change its state from waiting state to start the next cycle. What is the next cycle it starts? It issues the prompt and wait for the user to enter the command. That is the next cycle. This is what the cycle that we have discussed in the previous class. The next thing is wildcards. For our simplification, in order to reduce our work, in using the Unix operating system, in order to do our work easily, these wildcards are supported in the Unix operating system. What is this wildcard? Is the meta characters, redirection operator, star, the slash, the single quotes, so what all those things what we use here, they are all the meta characters. That the meta characters what we use to define the rules. What we do is we use the meta characters and we'll define a rules that is called as a pattern. That's the meta characters that we call it as a wildcards. Which are the wildcards which are supported? Star, CA, question mark, this big bracket and big brackets, this exclamatory mark, all those things. In that we have started discussing this star. What is this star? Is the star is going to match all the characters including none, zero or more it is indicated by the star. Example, in the last class I have shown you there is a folder called cd dir oct. October 1st I have created one folder cd dir oct
It should be single C, change directory. Then inside that there are so many other folders are there. LS chapter star. See, so many files are there. CHAP star, CHAP 112, CHAP 12. The six files are there. These six files, it has been listed because of this meta character, a star, which is a wild card. In the same way, even instead of this, if you use see which are the files which are there inside that folder, let us check which is the inside the folder. See, these many files are there. The same thing that you can see in the terminal here, CHAP. Even with the echo star also, it will list all the files. The next thing is question mark. The question mark is, it is going to match the single character. Match the single character is, I want to match the file names which has five characters. That should start with CHAP. In this list, how many files are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 8, 12 files are there. In that, the number of characters should be 5 and the file name should start with CHAP. If I want to do that, then LS CHAP question mark, if I enter, it is going to match the file names CHAP star, CHAP 2, CHAP 3. These are the files which has five characters. This question mark, it matches for single character. Even though CHAP is there in this folder, it is not going to match because it is not zero or more, it is only one. It will expect for one character at that place. That is the meaning of question mark. It's a single character. If you add one more question mark, as simple as that, it is straightforward. Two characters it is expecting after CHAP. That is why six characters. Any file name which starts with the CHAP, six characters should be there. That is why CHAP 12. The next thing is, the next thing is this question star and question mark, it is not going to include the files which are hidden. The hidden files are not included, and also it will not match the slash. That is the exclusion of this two wildcards, star and question mark. The star and question mark is not going to include the hidden files. Remember, star and question mark is not going to include the hidden files. In order to do this, you have to mandatorily include this star. There are files which starts with the, you have to see, there is a file semo.demo is there. If you want to include the dot, then you have to include the dot in the file name. See, semo and semo.demo is included. If you want just the dot files, you can directly include the dot in the command itself. That is why, and also the hidden files. If the dot is in between, you are going to include the dot in the command in middle, or else all the files will be listed here. The next thing is matching the dot. This means this is what I was telling, the hidden files. hidden files is nothing but say ls dot question mark question mark question mark star. This indicates it is going to list all the hidden files. At least 3 characters is expected. After that, any number of name. After that, any number of characters. The output of this command is the first character is dot. The meaning of that is it will only list the hidden files. After that, that hidden files file name mandatorily it should have 3 characters. After that, 0 or any number of characters. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Any number of characters. Maximum, we know, it is 255 characters. This is how we are going to match the dot. The next thing is character class. See, this character class is the range of file names you want to extract. See, in this folder, I want the file names of some particular class. If it is not possible in case of the star, some things it is not possible with the star wildcard. For that, we'll go for this character class. What we do is, see chapter 2, chapter 3, and I'll rename this to chapter 4. I'll rename this to chapter 1. See, I want only these 3 file names. If I want these 3 file names, if I use chapter star, I'll get all these file names. Which one? All these file names I'm going to get. These 5. Sorry, 6. If I use chap star, I'll get all these 6 file names. I want only the file name chapter 2, chapter 3, chapter 4. In that case, which is the better is this character class. How is ls chap 224. See, I have defined the character class, the range from chapter 2 to 4. It includes chapter 2, chapter 3, chapter 4. Like this, you can list the file names. It is all for searching the files. See, always the internet is all about you are going to search and find something in the internet, right? For that, in order to reduce our work in the background, how they are going to get you all the files that you wanted so quickly is like this. They are going to use the regular expressions, so many other algorithms in the background, and they will get you the files in the internet. That is what we are discussing here, the regular expressions, how they are going to quickly get you the files. If you want just only chapter 1 and 2, like this you can do. Chapter 1, 2. If there is no range, if there is no range, you can directly write like this. Instead of writing 1, 2, 3, 4, like this, you can avoid, like this, you can write 1, 2, 4. See, if I use the exclamatory mark here, if I use the exclamatory mark, chapter within the brackets, exclamatory mark 1 to 4. The meaning of that exclamatory mark is negation. Don't include the files CHAP1, CHAP2, CHAP3 and CHAP4. And get me other files. Other than chapter 1 to chapter 4, get me other files with starting with the 4 character CHAP. Therefore, these are this. In this file, 5 files, I have negated the first 4 files. I don't want these 4 files. I want only this one. In that case, what I'll do is, I'll use this negation operator in the... I'll use the negation operator in the character class. That indicates don't include those files. Remember, without exclamatory mark, with exclamatory mark. With the range, hyphen, when the hyphen should be used, or else directly you can write all the classes. See here, ls data 01, 02, 03, 04. See, 3 is not there. Chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3, chapter 4, it matches. File X to Z. If you write file X, file Y, file Z. In the same way, if you use the negation, then it is not going to list those files. I'll rename the some files. The file name is Java. Next, the other file name is .c file. The other file name is Python file py. The other file name is demo.cpp. See, so many files are there. I'll list it. There is a Python file .py is there, .java, .cpp, .c, and also we'll rename doc.txt file. These many file extensions are there. I want all the files excluding this .c file and .py file. I'll rename this to .o also. I don't want these two files, .o files and .c files. If I don't want these two files, .o file and .c file, what I should do is ls star any file in the bracket negation, which I don't want is negation. I don't want C file. I don't want O file. But it is a file extension. Means there is after dot I am expecting. That is why dot here. Star dot. I don't want C file. I don't want dot O file. Then why it is no such file or directory? It is inside the directory, right? Where it is going to list. Okay, it is going to list those two files. If I use the negation, what happened? The file is not properly created, I think. We'll check ls star. No. The negation of C is, it is showing negation of single character. We'll make this as file dot semo dot dot j. This one file dot tempo demo dot p. Now we'll check. See, now it is, what is the problem was, it was expecting for a single character. It is expecting for single character of the dot. That is why it was not showing. Say ls star dot negation of c is, if I don't want C file, after the dot, single characters are dot O, dot P, and dot J files are there. That is why, if I don't want these files, it is going to list the other files. If I don't want C files and O files, object file, then Java file dot J and dot p. If you want to write more than one characters, for that there is another way of writing. I'll show that also. I assume that you have understood the meaning of this negation. The next thing is this one. Within the Java file and C file, which I was talking about. The C file and Java files, if you want to copy, you have to use this flower bracket. This is what? The flower brackets you have to use. If you use this flower brackets, you can write the dissimilar patterns, the different patterns. It can be a C file, Java file, Python file. Here, what this file is going to do is, it is going to copy, CP is copy, the path is inside the home folder. Inside the home folder, there is another folder called program sources. Inside that, there are files. Which are the files? There are files starting from .c and .java. Where I want to copy? I want to copy to the .dot. It indicates the current directory. I'm at different location. I want to copy it to the current directory. The .dot indicates current directory. Only C files and Java files. In that case, you can do like this. For that, you have to use this curly braces, flower brackets. You cannot use this one. Flower brackets, why we are using is, see, if you use this one, this brackets, what is the problem is, it will expect only for single character, dot C, dot O. Just now I did, right? Dot Java have replaced with dot J. For that reason itself, they are going to use this flower bracket. If you use this flower bracket, then you can use comma. You can use, this is not the command that you want to use with the which one? We have to use this with the copy command. Just I have tried with the ls command. And also make a note that if the terminal what you are using, if it is a bourne shell, there are so many shells are there. I have told you some of the Unix operating system supports some shell. In my Unix operating system, it is using bash shell. See, it is a bash shell. It is using ps command. If you enter, you will get which shell it is using. And this is a note, it is not going to run, it does not work in the bourne shell. Which one? This dissimilar patterns. Remember this. So to summarize this, say some of the command ls *c means it is going to list all the files which file name ending with .c. mv star dot dot slash bin means it is going to move the files from the move all the files to the bin directory. See here, the first is star, after that dot slash slash bin. It is not visible, you can like this. Star slash means go to this bin directory and move all the files from the current directory. Copy file one, copy file to the file star. Copy question mark means the five character file names. Everything you are going to copy to the this programs folder means directory. Five character file name yagadidya adelladu illi copy agutte. In the same way, this one rm, this rm, it is going to remove all the files with the three character extensions. See, it is showing you the three characters extension. One is slash l, means exclamatory mark L, exclamatory O, and exclamatory G means I don't want to include dot log extension. This ls data means the class is different now. Data 0, data 1. Data 0 to 1 means data 0, data 1. If you have included another character class, means that letter will also be included. That character will also be included. Data 0, 0. 0, 1. What, how many possibilities? 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 2, 0, 3, 0, 4, 0, 5, 0, 6, 0, 7, 0, 9. After that, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, up to 1, 9. These many files it is going to list. If you use one more flower brackets, three characters, all the match, map, it is going to match. If you use this hyphen R, it is recursive. Recursively, it is going to copy from this source. The source is home, inside that SRM folder, inside that C files and Java files. Where it should copy? It should copy dot. Dot indicates current directory. From some other location, copy only the C files and Java files to the current directory. That is the meaning of this CP, copy. See, you have to practice this because in the test or in the exam, we can be asked like this. Write a command to copy all the Python files and the Java files from this particular directory. Then you have to write this command. In the test, we'll ask from this end. We'll write a sentence. You have to read that sentence, understand, and you have to write the command. Copy from this location to this location. Then copy command. Remove all the files with the file extension. Number of characters is 5. Commands. See, any commands we can ask, but we are not going to ask from this end. What is the output of this command? You have to write the command, but we are going to give it in the form of sentence, a statement. That is why you have to practice all the commands that we have discussed till now. I will give you 2 minutes. Please send your attendance. Then we'll continue this escaping and quoting.